What is going on, my Atomic Auto Works friends? Today, we're wet sanding. We're down to the last fender. So I figured, what better way to show you how we do it than to show you how we do it? Now, a little disclaimer, this video is not for you to run out and do this to your mom's Honda. You really have to know the material that you're putting down, how much clear coat, all that stuff. There's a lot of factors to factor in. We're simply showing you how we do this specific step of our build. Now, if you go to our website, atomicautoworks.com, you'll see we offer multiple structures for paint for cars, trucks, and motorcycles. We have a pre-owned vehicle one, which is basically we put down an inexpensive clear coat or base coat and clear coat. It looks really nice. No wet sanding, no buffing, no warranties. It's the best bang for your buck, low budget paint job. And then they move up to OE paint jobs, which we duplicate the original vehicle's paint job like a new vehicle would be, which is a little bit nicer than the used car one. And then we have our local show and more of a national show. And the difference between the local and national show is quite a bit. You know, so like, well, each step of it is quite a bit for every single process we do. This one here, it's not really supposed to be a local show quality paint job, but it is. We're doing a really nice job on it. We want the customer's truck to look beautiful. What we do in this instance, which you'll see, is we actually clear coat the vehicle, and this one we actually did kind of five coats of clear coat. So we put like a tack coat of clear on there, and then we put four really good coats of clear. You don't want heavy running clear, but you want to make sure you have enough material. If you're worried about running the paint, you're better off doing an extra coat and doing them drier. So as long as you have the buildup of material on there, when you sand it, you're not going to go through. And this one here, we get very aggressive, and you'll see why. Actually, I'm going to show you the sandpapers that we use, and then we'll go through the buffing and polishing as well. So this is the layout that we're going to do. Very aggressive. We're starting with 600, then 800, then 1,000. 1200, 1500, and 2000, all with a hard block by hand. For this, because it's not like a national level show car that we're doing, we hit it with a DA with 2000, 3000, and 5000. Whereas if you're doing more of a national level high competition vehicle, you'd block it by hand all the way through. As I begin, one of the disclaimers is we're starting off with 600 grit wet sandpaper. Very, very aggressive. The reasons why I say you do not try this on your regular vehicles or anything like that, because you will sand through without a doubt. The clear coats that are on most of the new cars are not a high solids or a very thin clear coat. They're made to go on thin, flat, look nice, but don't have buildup. The stuff we use is very thick, very heavy, high build, and it builds some serious millage. So what we're going to end up doing is basically taking one layer of clear coat completely off, and maybe even a little bit more. The reason we're doing this isn't because we have some really nasty fender with problems all over and stuff like that. The 600 grit on a hard block is gonna level it out and give us a flat cut surface so that it gives you a lot better gloss reflection and no urethane wobble, so you don't really see any angling in the actual clear coat, and it cuts out all of the, obviously, any texture or orange peel that would be in there. The orange peel isn't bad. You could take 1000 grit and would cut that out of these things, but this levels it out and gives it a way better look. You have to be careful because this is very aggressive. So now we're gonna go through, and what I like to do is get the surface wet. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Count your passes with your sandpaper, squeegee it off, get it. Make sure there's no imperfections, which there still are. So I'm gonna go through and do it again. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I like to count, because then you know exactly where you are for your building. So now, once you know at the certain amount of sanding you do, you could actually just go through. So I'm gonna do 18 passes on this, and that'll be good for the 600. So now I'm just gonna go through and do 18 here. Okay, so we got 18 passes. We're gonna look, make sure it's good, and it looks great. So now we're gonna go through and do the rest of the fender. You really have to be careful around any sharp body lines. If you're new to this, you could put tape across the body line so you don't hit it. You don't want to hit body lines with 600, 800 grit, anything there, even 1000 grit. You got to be really careful. So we like to sand right up and off of them, but not actually hit them, so you don't go through. But you have to go through and hit the entire, every surface of this fender has to get hit with this, so it's all uniform. Everything's sanded with 600. I'm gonna dry this off, and we're gonna take a look and see what we missed, because you always miss something. Every time, there's always something. Right, so another thing I do wrong is in between every coat, I use this 3M inspection spray to clean it up so I could see exactly where my scratches are, what I missed. I don't think this is supposed to be used for this. It really is probably just for when you're in between buffing, and we're not buffing, we're sanding. But I love this stuff. It dries really quick. Gives it like long enough to that it stays wet long enough for you to clean it, but then it dries up really good, and then you could really see the panel underneath it. And I didn't go crazy with this 600. I don't want to go too crazy. You don't want to take off too much material, but you want to level this out. When I say level it out, that's one of the reasons why you have to be careful, is if you have really bad body work and you didn't do the body work with a really hard block, now you're standing with 600, which is still kind of aggressive. Well, it's aggressive for paint, but it definitely could actually level stuff out, which means if you have some highs and lows and now you're using a hard block, you could cut right through those. You really, really got to be careful. So I found a bunch of spots that I missed. I'm going to show you and then make a decision. All right, so you can see there's still shiny spots. I didn't hit the edges with 600, and there's actually some spots that have, you see right there, it's still shiny. So there's really, it's leveling out like I wanted to, but I don't know if I want to go through, see shiny spots here, and there's an imperfection right there. So there's like a piece of dirt nib that was in there. So I could go over that with a 600 grit again, which I'm probably gonna just do one shot with 600. I went through and actually ended up hitting all those areas with 600 on the hard block. I find that if you see like a dirt nib or an imperfection and you sand it and sand it till the second it's gone, if you come back, a lot of times it's still there. So what I usually do is it's gone, then I do a few more passes, then it's really gone. So when you buff it out, there's no imperfections. Also, if you hit it with a 600 now, everything we're doing afterwards is literally sanding to just get rid of the sand scratches that we put in. So we're not really worried about making the panel look a lot better. We're just getting rid of the scratches that we put in. And honestly, when you look at this panel sanded in 600 grit, you're like, I'm never gonna buff this thing out. There's no way it's gonna have a shine. It's such a coarse, you could hear it. It's such like a really coarse sanding, and you would never think that it would work, but it does. So now we're gonna go on to 800 grit wet sanding. And what we're gonna do is you can see the scratches in the direction that we did before. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna sand in a different direction. So these sand scratches here are going like this. So I'm gonna sand like this. Once those sand scratches are gone, I'll count as I'm doing it. And when they're gone, that's how much I'm gonna do across the entire panel. And that should pretty much ensure that we took out all the 600 grit scratches with the 800 grit paper. So let's try this now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see where we're at here. I'm gonna do 8. It looks like it's pretty close. You can hear it when you're sanding, how aggressive it is. You can feel the paper grabbing it. You wanna make sure you keep it wet. A lot of times you just put a little dish soap, dropper to a dish soap in your water, and the paper, sandpaper glides a lot more. I always gotta make sure right up to the body lines and the edges. A lot of people neglect all the areas that are the problem. So like curved areas, body lines, if you don't sand up to them and get them really good, when you go to buff it out, it's gonna be your problem area. And it's always around these edges that we get scared, we don't wanna sand through. So let's see this. Okay, so now we're gonna sand down here. Anytime you get around a curved area, you gotta be careful because the paint rolls off that. A flat panel, it lays out and builds up a lot. So you don't wanna over sand any sharp or curved areas because there's not the same amount of material on there. Okay, let's see where we're at here. Okay, so I'm gonna go through, do this to the entire panel. Just wet sand it again. Now this is with 800. So you can still see I didn't hit the body lines. I even left all these edges. I just don't want to take a chance with anything super aggressive. As far as the panel itself, it's very flat. Even these edges, I didn't hit hard because the material, the clear coat always wants to just roll off here. So it settles up here and it's nice and thick, but it's going to roll off here and be thinner. So we're still being careful, but it's flat. It's cut. There's nothing wrong with it. No real imperfections, but you can see this is some serious coarse sanding. Can you see that? Now this 1000 grit is still coarse, it's still aggressive, and it still takes off a lot of material, so we want to be careful. What we're trying to do is get rid of the 800 grit scratches, make sure there's no imperfections. I'm going to start hitting some of these body line areas here a little bit just to make sure that there's nothing wrong with them, and then we're going to do this a little more aggressive than the 800. So we did for the 600, I think we did between 12 and 17 passes, and then the 800, I did about 8 or 9 passes. I think I'm gonna do about 13 passes on each one with the 1,000 to make sure that the 800 and 600 grit scratches are gone. It's even though we're doing 600, 800, 12, 15, 2,000, 3,000, 5,000, it's really fine grit. If we come back with a compound on a wool pad and a Super Duty compound, which is very aggressive too, technically that takes out 1,000 grit scratches. So if there's any 800 or 600 grit scratches in there, it's not gonna take those out. And you don't wanna be at the end doing your buffing and realize there's some huge gouges. That's another reason why I like to wash in between every single sanding. You don't need to, but if you clean it really good, dry it off, and then hit the next sandpaper, you could look and see if there's any really big scratches in there. And you could also have a better chance of leveling it without putting anything, any scratches into it. Another thing I forgot to mention is when you're sanding, you're listening. If you hear a little scratch or anything aggressive on it, stop immediately, rinse everything off. Sometimes change your sandpaper, whatever it takes, and then go back and hit that area again. Because what happens is if there's a little dirt nub or something like that in the paint, when you sand that, it could come out, or even like a balled up piece of clear coat could come out. And then when you sand that, you're gonna put some really heavy scratches and you don't want that. I'm gonna take this and we're gonna come at it from a different angle. I'm gonna wet the panel down. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And you can kind of see when it's wet, you can see the reflection, you can kind of see the scratches underneath there, so you can pay attention to what you're doing. So I wanna make sure that we're getting the 800 grit scratches. So 12, 13 is gonna be our ticket. So now we're just gonna go through at a different angle here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 1. An old timer once told me, he asked me if I count when I sand. And I said, yes, I do. And he said, well, you'll probably be a good body man because you have to count. And I always stuck in my head for the last 30 years. So here we go. We're gonna go right up this body line here. You gotta be careful. And I'm just gonna right across here. Right up to it and then right across here. If you pay attention to these areas when you buff it, you'll buff right by them and everything will be fine. If you don't sand these things, you're gonna have heavy scratches and then you'll be trying to buff the hard parts to buff. So I always make sure that we really fine tune these areas and make sure there's no sand scratches. Now you're starting to see too, it's not as aggressive. It's starting to get smoother. Like whereas that 600 and 800 grit were very, very aggressive, you're starting to feel like the paper's gliding through a little bit better and it's starting to just look better. Now we're at 1200 grit, so we're getting there. It's starting to look a little bit smoother. This will actually make it a little smoother looking and a little easier to sand. One thing I forgot to say, because we've been hammered on this before, is yes, I'm using a water bottle to squirt water on here. We get people that will chime in and say, they make spray bottles. Why don't you use a spray bottle? You know, why don't you use a bucket? Everybody does something different, and I don't care how you get the panel wet. This is how I do it. And the buckets, sometimes I've had where you go in there and you scoop it, and then there's dirt that came off of this that's still in there that gets in there. So you want to make sure your water buckets are filled really high to the top so the dirt settles to the bottom so you don't scratch a panel. Squirt bottles, to me, don't put off enough material. So you got to sit there, squirt, 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 just to sand. This stuff here, I can just dump it on if I want to or dribble it on if I want to. So now I'm going to dribble on the water and sand it with 1200, and we're gonna go at a different direction than the last one. 1, 2, 3, actually 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we're gonna do 11 passes. Let me just make sure. That's how much I did. I already sanded two doors, the other fender and the hood, so I kind of know how many passes I need to make, and that looks great. All right, I'm at 1500 grit. Can you see that? 1500 grit wet sandpaper. So what I am going to do right now is sand it with 1500. I'm gonna jump to 2000 on a block, and then we're gonna go to the DA to 2000. Another stupid thing I do, and the reason I do it is, for some reason, if I go 1500 and then go right to 2000 with the DA and hit it all down, a lot of times there's still scratches and stuff that's through there and it doesn't buff as nice. I find that if I hit it with 2000 on a block, and then hit it with 2,000, 3,000, and 5,000 with the DA, it comes out a lot nicer. And then obviously on the super show cars, high-end paints, you know, we use a block for 3,000, 5,000 straight through, and we don't even mess with the DAs. Okay, I moved the camera. I'm hoping that this will be a better angle. And I hope you can hear me because the compressor's going. So I'm gonna go with the DA with 2,000 grit. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do 8 passes. I like to do 8 passes for 2,000, 8 passes with 3,000, 8 passes with 5,000. So here we go. So I'm going to clean this off, and then I'm going to show you what it looks like close up between each stage of the 2000, 3000, and 5000. This is my favorite part because you start to see some progress. The 2000 now is starting to look a little shiny. You can see a little reflection on it. One thing I also forgot to mention too is I like to use a new piece of paper, the whole setup, 600, 800, 12, 1000, 12, 15, 2000, 3000, 5000, every time I change a panel, just because it's easier to make sure you cut the scratch below. So if you were at 1000, you make sure you cut your 800, you know, so on and so forth. And sometimes when you're reusing paper, you know, 1000 grit might sand or wear a little quicker than the 800. And then the next thing you know, you're not really taking out those scratches, and it seems to work a little better for me. So here is the 2000. It's still a little wet because I just wiped it down, but you can kind of get the gist of it. Starting to get a little bit of a gloss to it. Okay, so with the 3000, I'm just going to go through and do the same thing. Try to do 8 passes. 1, 2, 3. All right, so here is the 3000 grit, all sanded. You can see it's starting to get pretty shiny. I mean, obviously there's wet spots from me just drying off, but it's starting to actually get shiny. Ready to move to the 5000. As you can see, these are blood, sweat, and tears. See, blood goes into every car on these things. A lot of sand in today. I want to try to buff this out and have it done, but we started in the dark. It's starting to get dark outside, and I think I might have to come in tomorrow to finish the buffing and to finish the final part of this video. But let's see if I get rejuvenated with a little bit of energy. Let's sand. Oh, look at that blood. Holy moly. Okay, 5,000. And 1, 2, 3, deja vu. 4, 5. Okay, so here is the 5,000 grit all cleaned up. And you can see it's shiny. And what's nice about when it's shiny is before you buff, you could find an imperfection. So right here, I missed a spot. Where is it? It is right there. Where's my finger? So when it's shiny, can you see it right there? It's kind of hard to see. But anyway, when it's shiny, you could actually see it. And now we'll sand it before we buff it. I'm gonna hit that one spot and then we're gonna buff it. All right. So if you did not, I almost tripped and knocked the fender over. If you did not cringe when I pulled out 600 grit paper and started sanding the clear coat, now you're going to cringe. We just sanded up the 5,000 grit, but we're going to go back to Super Duty compound, which is very heavy, very coarse, and a wool pad. Now, you don't have to do this. I like how it comes out. This will cut it really flat. A lot of the compounds rely on heat to kind of melt the paint. This will actually sand it and keep it flat. I like how it comes out better. So I'm going to hit it with Super Duty and a wool. And I'm also going to hit it with the number one compound, which is our first step, with a wool. And then also that one with a foam. So get ready to go backwards in life here, guys. I use a lot of compound, which you're not supposed to do, and a low speed. You're not supposed to put it directly on the panel. Okay, so I just cleaned off Super Duty and a wool pad. So we're getting every bit of grit, grime, and grease off of that thing. So this is number one wool pad. You can see there's a lot of fine scratches that the wool pad actually puts in there. You see over there. Okay, so we're doing our first step here. Still number one with the wool compound. We're gonna do this with this, and then we're gonna do this again with the foam pad. And again, they say never put your compound on there. Never use that much. Okay, here we go. Number one, step one, with a foam pad. So this is step one with the foam pad. And now we are going to move to step two with the foam pad. All right, okay, so we're gonna go to number three, which is our final one. tell you, with each step, it keeps getting better. Even though it's not a show truck, I tell you what, if you brought this to a show, I don't think it's going to do too bad. Now let's do the third buff and final one with the circular buffer. Okay, so here is the third and final buff with the circular buffer. And now we're going to go to the orbital. And here is the first of the random orbital completion. We're going to do one more. And if you really see, it's hard because certain colors don't really show the depth that you really want, because this is a silver. Now, when this is back together, we're gonna have to kind of go through and do all the minor blemishes that we missed and do a final buff. But one more polish and let's see what that looks like. All right, so that was the final with the random orbital for now. We're gonna put this together. And I'm sure there's going to be something that we're going to have to deal with. Paint correction after final assembly, there always is. And we'll go through with this like a fine tooth nail. We'll go through in a lot of detail and make sure that there's no blemishes on this. But we're going to do it when it's together now. This way we can put it together. 99% of all the hard work's been done. We can put it together. We'll go through and hit the problem areas. I think I'm just so tired from doing this today that I can't even think right. But we'll go through and hit all the final details and get that done. When the truck's together, let me show you this, and I'm getting the hell out of here because it was a long day and I'm extremely tired. It's very, very dark outside and I don't like that. Missed the day.